Finally, there's something very curious about modern Western civilization. I consider it to be the most important thing of all. What is it? It appears to be a civilization that is essentially godless. It appears to be a civilization that is committed to materialism. It is a civilization which is constantly attacking religion and the religious way of life. And as a consequence of that war on religion, religion is in a state of decline around the world today. Yet, the reality is that modern Western civilization has come to be as a consequence of a reconciliation, a curious reconciliation, a rapprochement between some Christians and some Jews. And yet strangely, mysteriously, mystifyingly, in modern Western civilization, the world has witnessed for the first time and for the only time, Jewish Christian friendship and alliance. So this is not really about this.
I used to say early on when I was a kid, I'd say when I was a young senator, I'd say, if I were a Jew, I'd be a Zionist. I am a Zionist. You don't have to be a Jew to be a Zionist. You don't have to be a Jew to be a Zionist.
So what brings you to Christians United for Israel?
Well, I was in on the ground floor. I've worked with John and Diana Hagee for many, many years on many different projects.
And how much of an inspiration is the Second Coming in your support for Israel?
Obviously, it's what I live for.
Really?
And I hope it comes tomorrow.
And God is doing a miraculous thing as now millions of Christians in the United States of America have rallied to the cause of Israel under Christians United for Israel, and we go to Washington once each year to give testimony to our congressmen and senators that we're Christians and that we're from your district and we vote for you or against you based on your support or lack thereof of the state of Israel.
Therefore, it is time for America to embrace the words of Senator Joseph Lieberman and consider a military preemptive strike against Iran to prevent a nuclear holocaust in Israel and to neutralize Iran.
I have a deep sympathy for the Jewish people, I think as Christians we owe them a deep apology for the incredible suffering that we've caused them over centuries, and that would apply also to Islam. I think that what they have gone through, and not least in the latter years under the Nazi Holocaust, I think is absolutely appalling, and the world did not help. So the modern state of Israel is almost a survival mechanism. I can understand why people who have been rejected by the world and treated like that should want a place of their own. Where I have a problem, though, is when Christians use the Bible to say that what's happening in Israel is a fulfillment of prophecy. Because when I was in Israel, what I found was a largely secular state. When you look at the way it operates vis-a-vis the Palestinians, you have to say it's founded on injustice and unrighteousness and cruelty. Now, if you're going to call that the fulfillment of prophecy, it has to be founded on righteousness.
What do we mean of this? If that was the end of the story, that is already strange enough, but there's more to come. Modern Western civilization has witnessed not only this Jewish-Christian reconciliation and alliance, but more than that. This is the civilization which has an obsession with the Holy Land. As a Christian do as a Jew. Modern Western civilization has displayed its obsession with the Holy Land. In many instances in history, how do we explain, for example, Britain, a secular state, 1917, and the British government issued the Balfour Declaration? What does it mean? That the British government will work for the establishment of a Jewish national home in the Holy Land. That false Messiah, in order to impersonate the true Messiah, must rule the world from Jerusalem, from a state of Israel. It is modern Western civilization which presided over the return of the Jews to the Holy Land. Without the modern West, they could not have done it. It is modern Western civilization which created the state of Israel. The European people did it, not the Oriental Jews. When Britain acted as the midwife for the state of Israel to be born in 1948, I believe it was 11 minutes later that the United States recognized Israel.